Let's now figure out how we can add data into a table. So we've got our cities table. We want to add in some information about the cities Tokyo, Delhi, Shanghai, and Sao Paulo. I've got the countries listed here, along with the populations and the areas as well. We want to take all these values and get them into the cities table. To do so, we're going to once again write out some SQL. So back over here, I'm going to delete the create table statement, and we will replace it with insert into. So these are the keywords that we use to insert some information into a table. We'll write out insert into, and then the name of the table, which in this case is cities. And then inside of a set of parentheses, we're going to add out a list of all the different columns or values for columns that we are going to provide. So we are going to provide a name, a country, a population, and an area. Then on the next line down, I'm going to put down another keyword, values. After the values keyword, we're then going to list out all the values that we want to put into this table inside of a set of parentheses. So the very first city we're going to add in here is Tokyo. So I'm going to put in a set of parentheses. I'm going to put in Tokyo inside of single quotes. Notice I'm using single quotes here, not double quotes. Then Japan. Then our population of 38,505,000. And then the square kilometers. So 8223. I'll then put a semicolon at the end of the line. Now you might have noticed that on the create table statement, we used a semicolon at the very end as well. Inside of the SQL standard, technically we do have to put in that semicolon, but in this interface, it is not actually required. So if you do not put on that semicolon at the very end of the SQL statement, that is technically okay, but I highly recommend you add it in, especially once you start to write in multiple statements inside of one query. All right, so let's now try to run this. And as soon as we do, we'll see insert successful, one row inserted into that table. Okay, so that's pretty much it. Now, what we've got here definitely works, but there's a little bit of trivia around the insert into statement that I just want you to be aware of very quickly. So first off, we listed out all the columns inside the cities table right here in a very distinct order. So name, country, population, area. If we wanted to, for some crazy reason, we could decide arbitrarily to kind of jumble the order of columns. The only requirement is that when we list out all the values we want to insert, they match up in the same order as the order in which we listed out all of our columns. So it has to map up in this way. Let's imagine what would happen if we swapped the word country with population right here. If we did this, that would mean that we want to insert the string Japan under the column population. And for country, we would want to insert the value 38 million. And that's definitely not what we want. So we just need to make sure that whenever we list out these different column names, we always provide the values to go in the same order as well. Okay, so now next little bit of trivia here. We want to insert three other cities, and it would be a little bit tedious to have to write out three separate statements three times over and run these three things just to get three rows into our table. So if we want to, we can actually insert multiple rows in a single statement in one go if we want. Let me show you how we do that. I'm going to delete everything after values. And then on the next line down, I'm going to open up another set of parentheses. And I'm going to list out all the values for Delhi, India. So I'll put in Delhi, India, which has a population of 28,125,000. And 2240 is the area. And then after I list out all the values for Delhi, India, I'll make sure I close off that set of parentheses, put a comma, and then on the next line down, I'll put in another set of values. So this additional set of values right here will be inserted as an additional row, all inside of the same query. Now we could put in Shanghai, China, the population of 22,125,000,415. I'll put another comma right there. And then finally, Sao Paulo in Brazil, 209,35,000, and an area of 3043. That's how we can insert multiple rows at a single time. Now I'll run that query. And now we can see in the output down here that we successfully inserted three separate rows. Okay, so that's how we insert one row at a time or multiple rows. Now the last thing we really have to do is figure out how to retrieve this information out of the cities table. Let's take a look at that in just a moment.